NBC2 is on top of a story you first saw as a notification on your phone. We sent this alert from our news app saying one of the two men facing the death penalty in the murder case of Dr. Teresa Sievers now wants his own trial. Jimmy Rogers wants his case separated from co-defendant Mark Sievers. The two had a trial scheduled for the start of October. NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis explains why a split could delay the trial even more.
That motion filed by Jimmy Rogers' team is not just about evidence in the case that both sides wouldn't be able to hear, but it's also about the logistics. Consider 12 people for Mark Sievers and 12 jurors for Jimmy Rogers sitting inside this box, as well as alternates. And imagine both defendants at the table.
The sheer complexity of these cases make it very difficult to try together. This may be the most complex case we've ever tried here in Lee County.
From evidential concerns to space curiosity, it remains a mystery how the two men could wind up on trial together. Legal expert and attorney Spencer Cordell says not only is it complex, but the stakes are high.
Paramount, especially on a death penalty case, is making sure they both get a fair trial.
In the motion to sever, attorneys for Jimmy Rogers point to potential conflicting defenses for co-defendant Mark Sievers and their client. They also say the piles of evidence could confuse jurors, having them connect both of the cases as one.
You just have such complex cases. To try to cram two of these into one trial is very, very difficult to do.
October 1st for trial call.
The next decision from the judge could change that scheduled trial, sending one man in front of a jury before the other.
Which one goes first, which one goes second? There's probably going to be a benefit to one. You don't know which that's going to be.
One of the most complex cases in the circuit, and a new layer of questions about what's ahead. In Lee County, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.